Assalamu alaikum. Alhamdulillah, Anas. My name is Maher. I'm a Muslim. However, my fiance, she's staying at the audience in the woman's side.
Sorry, we said that everything is non-Muslim.
All right, but the question is, my fiance, she's there, but she's non-Muslim.
Can she ask the question?
She's shy to ask. She will not ask it. That's why I'm there.
Okay, fine. We make an exception.
All right. She's from Christian family. She's from Germany. However, I show her the Quran with all the scientific miracles. She believes it's a word of God. She believes Muhammad is a final messenger. But she does not really believe that we'll be really resurrected and God will judge us or heaven and hell, because it's not like scientifically have been approved. I just would like to ask you for some advices.
What's the background? She's a Christian?
She's a Christian, yes. But she does not believe like Jesus is God or the Son of God or something.
The brother said that he has a fiancé who believes that in Allah, believes in Quran, believes in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but does not believe that we'll be resurrected. So is there any scientific proof to say that? The best reply you can give, that if you analyze the Quran, number one, Quran is not a book of science, S-C-I-E-N-C-E, but it's a book of signs, S-I-G-N-S. It's a book of ayats. And as you said that you have proof to her many scientific facts about astronomy, the Quran speaks of biology, about zoology, about embryology, about geology, and she has heard that. Now she wants to know what is the scientific proof about hereafter, about life after death. For this, I would like to tell you that Quran has got more than 6,000 verses, out of which more than 1,000 speak about science. Now, if you analyze, there is not a single verse in the Quran which has been proved unscientific. So whatever the Quran says, 80% approximately has been proved to be right. The balance 20% is ambiguous. Neither right, neither wrong. Quran speaks about astronomy, biology, physiology, embryology. Now, Quran speaks about jinn. Science hasn't proved that. Quran speaks about life after death. Science hasn't proved that. Quran speaks about heaven and hell. Science hasn't proved that. So I would say 80% what the Quran says has been proved to be 100% correct. The remaining 20% is ambiguous. Neither right, neither wrong. There is not a single verse of the Quran which has been proved to be unscientific. Correct? So my logic says when 80% is 100% correct and the remaining 20% is ambiguous, so my logic says, inshallah, even this 20% would be correct. It's a logical belief. It's not a blind belief. So tell her that if not even 0.01% has been proved to be wrong, not a single verse has been proved to be unscientific, but science hasn't advanced so far to speak about life after death. Science hasn't advanced so far to speak about heaven and hell. But when 80% has been proved to be 100% correct, inshallah, the balance 20% also will be right.
Inshallah. Hope thank you so much.
Now we have another non-Muslim that she wants to ask a question.